In a previous video in this series, we looked at our direct online starter and we saw how we use that to start a single phase motor, and then we had a look at some variations on that theme, didn't we? Using remote start stops and multiple stop devices.
Indicator lamp.
Exactly, that's right. So what are we going to be looking at in this video then, Matt?
So this time around, we're looking at the exactly the same direct online starter, but this time it's going to be operating a three phase motor.
Okay.
Previously, single phase motor, this time it's a three phase motor.
Right, brilliant.
Important thing to remember is everything remains the same.
Yep.
Even the coil is still a 230 volt coil.
Right, okay.
So it's a three phase,
yep,
but 230 volt coil.
Sure. And because it's a 230 volt coil, that means we're going to have to bring a neutral into this system.
So the neutral won't be going through to the motor.
Just for that.
Is the neutral will be. The supply will need a neutral going to it.
Fantastic.
So we have our three lines coming in.
Yep.
We have L1 coming in to number one contact.
Yep.
L2 coming to number three, and L3 coming to number five.
Very good. Now again, you know, perhaps someone approaching this for the first time might go, my neutral will go in there.
But obviously,
that's definitely not going to happen.
Yeah. And again, we've got our three phase motor here, and it simply just goes all the way through, through the overload relay.
Very nice.
And straight down to our three phase motor.
It's just worth noting as well, on certain manufacturers of overloads, you find that these pins move, don't you? You can sort of move them from one position to another depending on what the physical size of the contactor is when you're screwing it on the bottom. So they kind of they click into different positions. So if you are struggling to get it in, it may be that one of the pins just needs
moving over. Because with these types of terminals, you can't go directly through the centre.
No.
It's either left or right.
Yeah.
Okay, so this in this situation, everything's so much more simple. Mm. There's no neutral to worry about bringing around. It's just nice and easy.
It's good.
Okay then, so we've still got our retaining contacts, numbers 13 and 14, and we need to take a phase to one of those.
Okay.
And so I always choose to take it from number one, just my joins.
Yeah, that's fairly standard practice, I think, isn't it?
I think so.
A lot of people do that, yeah. And again, it's a microscopic load here, isn't it? So it's not going to cause any issues if you've got lots of coils connected onto L1.
Again, we've got our start button over there. Mm-hmm. So in this time, we're going to come across all the way to our start here.
Very nice.
And again, through the other side of the normally open contacts, we're going to take from number 14 all the way across to number 18.
And again, we're seeing what we saw before, that the start button and the auxiliary contact here, the latching contact, they are in parallel with each other.
Brilliant. Yeah. And so everything looks pretty much the same as how it was before.
Yeah.
And again, we need to take down from number 18 down to the stop button.
Yeah.
And again, from the stop button all the way across to the normally closed terminations of 95 and 96.
So this is our overload contact.
That's the overload contact.
Brilliant.
Okay. And then again, we're going from 96 back.
And I'm going to go up onto A1 now.
A1.
Yep, very nice. Yep.
And so that's where we got before. That's exactly the same.
Yep.
So we've got our circuit going through there. The only thing that's missing is our neutral conductor. And this time, the neutral's got nothing to do with any of the terminations. The neutral just simply comes into
just as a separate conductor there, and then into terminal A2. Very nice.
Into there.
Very good. So again, we've got that circuit completed, and we're seeing that same principle that we saw before. If I press the start button, I create a path that the current can flow through. It will flow through there and up to A1, bringing my coil in, which is fantastic. And when the coil comes in, these shoot over, making a contact not only to the motor, which will then be energised, but also between terminals 13 and 14, which means that when I take my finger off the button, current can then flow
back through the circuit.
Through the circuit again. Fantastic.
So just basically bypassing the stop button.
Fantastic.
Sorry, the start button.
So
that's basically the three-phase circuit for a direct online starter.
That's brilliant.
We'll just talk about we spoke about 95 and 96. Mm-hmm. 97, 98, it's exactly the same. You can still have an indicator lamp.
Yep.
We won't draw it on this one.
Yep.
But you can do it because we've got a neutral up there, so we can still have an indicator lamp there. The setting of the overload, that's important to know.
Yeah.
Because say for example, if we had a if it was a single phase, three kilowatt, that would be approximately 13 amps.
Yeah, thereabouts.
Whereas if it's a, as this is a three phase, say, three kilowatt motor, it's going to be roughly just 4 amps or something like
so
that.
So a third of the the current on a single phase load. Yeah, very good. And if you'd like to know the reasoning behind that and the maths behind that and some of the mathematical formulas behind that, then please head over to Joe Robinson Training, our Science and Principles channel, and you'll find there lots of information on that subject as well.
Okay, so I think I'm quite happy with really, I think that's what it is. Nice. It
shows actually, everything's okay. Again, you know, being three phase, it's not scary, is it? There's nothing more complicated about it. No. It's just a matter of understanding that we're going to use all the contacts for the three phases to the motor. Notice there's no neutral going to the motor because it's a balanced load, so we don't need a neutral in most cases. And we can see that the neutral just goes on to A2. So actually, it's almost as simple, if not a little bit simpler than the single phase connection.
And again, we didn't talk about it last time, but the there's the earth connection, and there's an earth connection on exposed metal work.
And we connect that up as we would for any load, obviously. Yeah, we're just not showing it on here for the sake of clarity and the sake of simplicity.
Yeah.
So, shall we sign this one off?
I think so.
Try and get it right this time, Matt. Okay, we've a bit more practice at this one, Okay, you ready? We hope this video has been some help. That was the best one we've done.